फ्रेंड्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। द बिगेस्ट चैलेंज दैट द वर्ल्ड इज फेसिंग एट द इंस्टेंट हैज मेड आवर लाइव्स वेरी माइजरेबल एंड लाइफ इज एट स्टेक। इट इज बेटर फॉर अस टू गो फॉर ऑफलाइन एंड ऑनलाइन मोड ऑफ टीचिंग्स so that our precious days may not get wasted. Government tried hard to reopen the schools, but it seems very difficult task for them to reopen schools before August because this COVID infection may separate when there would be mass gathering. So in these days, it is better to remain in home confinement and opt online and offline mode of teachings so that something is better than nothing and you can prepare yourselves for coming examinations that shall be taken online or whatever the policy government has in mind. And today I am devising a new way of teaching without using whiteboard to teach students. Sometimes it is necessary not to make use of whiteboard. Through communication skills, our students should learn something. And today we are dealing with a text lesson of class 10th, subject English, that is sermon at Banaras. First of all, we need to know what is sermon. Sermon is just a religious discourse, a religious talk delivered by a religious man, such as a saint or we may say prophet. This is the story of a mother whose child died in his lap. She was very deep in his grief. She wandered here or there, she knocked every door, she went to every doctor or every, we can say, medical man to make my child alive. But she can't get his child to life again because all the people said to him that a dead child can't be taken back or would come back. Finally, he reaches to a religious person, Gautam Buddha, who left his worldly life, or we can say worldly, prosperous life at the age of 20 and wandered here and there, and finally he got enlightenment. When Kisa Gautami, the mother, reached with his dead child in her arms to Gautam Buddha, she requested Gautam Buddha to make my dead child alive. In order to teach him lesson that death is an ultimate reality, it is irreversible change, and same change can't be reversed, he asked her to bring some seeds of mustard. But you need to bring seeds of mustard from that very harvest where no death has taken place, whether it is death of an elderly man, it is death of a woman, it is death of a child. She went door to door, asked for the mustard seeds, and everybody was ready to give some mustard seeds, but the condition she put before them was to, in your home there must be no death, and I need that mustard. If there is no death in your homes, no death has occurred in your homes, I need your mustard. But everybody at every door, she got the answer, death has taken place and we are ready to give you mustard seeds, but your condition that you are putting before us is impossible. In our homes, deaths have taken place. Finally, she reaches to a wayside. She was fatigued, she was very tired. She saw a bulb, electric bulb, glowing, and after some time extinguishes. She understood that the life is for a short time and then it has to go. Just like a bulb, it glows for a time and after a fixed time it distinguishes, extinguishes, this light extinguishes. When he reached Buddha back, she told Buddha that I can't brought the seeds, but because everybody was ready to provide me the mustard seeds, but deaths have taken place in every house, so the condition laid by me was impossible for them. But in the end, the Buddha taught him the lesson that death is an ultimate reality and this is an irreversible change, and the same change cannot come back. In this way, a religious man, religious saint, make her learn that the death is ultimate reality and everyone has to die on his turn. But this is all about the summary of the poem, some sermon at the Banaras. But it's better for you to see these things on the reference books and English textbooks, because nowadays very good reference books are available in markets, and also there is other sources of knowledge, that is the mobile network, or we can say the present communication system is a best source of knowledge. Your knowledge explosion is here. Get these things also from the other books or other sources of knowledge, so that you may grasp this, you may get the crux or the summary of this very topic in detailed manner. But before leaving the class, I am advising you to restrict your movements outside, minimize your physical contact so that this COVID infection may not reach to you. Thanks. Tomorrow I shall be live again for next class. Take care and be well, I said.